Hello everyone, myself Mrs. Sonali Dev, I welcome you to my channel Dev's Institute. Here is the second video on permutation, that is permutation part 2. I request you to subscribe to my channel Dev's Institute and click on bell icon to get instant notification when I upload new videos to the channel. Definition. This is just a review from the last YouTube lecture. Permutation is an arrangement of elements in a sequence, and permutation is applied where order of an element is important. This is the formula for permutation. NPR is equal to n factorial divided by n minus r factorial, where n is the number of objects and r is the number of places. There are basically four types of problems. First one is when all objects are distinct, and which we have covered in my previous video. And in this video, we'll focus on rest of the three types, that is when all objects are not distinct, when repetition of object is allowed, and when objects are to be arranged in a circle. Okay. So here the first type is when all objects are not distinct. Formula for permutation when all objects are not distinct. Consider that R1 objects are of kind 1, R2 objects are of second kind, and Rk objects are of kth kind, where R1 plus R2 plus R3 up to Rk is equal to n. Then total number of permutation when all are taken at a time is given by n factorial, where n is equal to number of total objects divided by R1 factorial, where R1 is the number of objects of one kind, R2 factorial, where R2 is the number of objects of second kind, multiplied by R3 factorial, where R3 is the number of objects of third kind, up to Rn or Rk, that means the number of objects of kth kind. Okay, so this is the first example. Find the number of permutations that can be made out of the letters MCCP and assassination. Okay, so in the first letter, in the first word MCCP, now here there are total 11 characters present in the word. So n is equal to 11, that is the total number of objects. Here s in this word, s is repeated 4 times, s is equal to 4, I is repeated 4 times, p is repeated 2 times, and m is repeated 1 time. So total number of permutations of this word is equal to 11 factorial, where 11 is the number of total number of characters divided by 4 factorial into 4 factorial into 2 factorial into 1 factorial. So 4 objects of type S, 4 objects of type I, 2 objects of type P, and 1 object of type M. So this will give you the total number of permutations possible for this word. The second word is assassination. In assassination, the total number of letters are 13, that is total number of objects 13. A is repeated 3 times, S is repeated 4 times, I is repeated 2 times, N is 2 times repeated, T contains 1 time, and O is contained 1 time. So the total number of permutations 13 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 4 factorial into 2 factorial into 2 factorial into 1 factorial into 1 factorial. 1 factorial is equal to 1. That's why we can neglect those terms also, which will be equal to the number shown over here. The second example, how many 7 digit numbers can be formed for using digits 1 7 2 7 6 7 6. So here n is equal to 7, that is total number of digits given 7. We have to form the 7 digit number. Here the number 7 is repeated 3 times and number 2 is repeated 2 times. The number 7 is repeated 3 times. Number 7 is repeated 3 times. Number 6 is repeated 2 times. So the total number of possible outcomes for digit numbers is 7 factorial, which is total number of the digits, divided by 3 factorial into 2 factorial into 1 factorial, because 1 is repeated 1 and 2 is repeated once. So 1 factorial into 1 factorial. We can neglect this 1 factorial, as 1 factorial is equal to 1. So we'll give you the total number of 7 digit number possible. That is 420. Third example, in how many ways can the letters in the word pioneer be arranged so that two E's are always together? So here in this letter, only the letter E is repeated 2 times and all other letters are present only single time. So here consider two E's as a single letter, because that two E's must always be together. So consider two E's as a single letter. So this will be considered as a single letter. So rest letters are 1, 2, 3, 4. This is 5 and 6. So these 6 letters can be arranged by using normal permutation formula, that is 6P6 ways, that is 6 factorial. So here, though the E is repeated, the E must be together, that is the condition. That's why these two E's is considered as a single unit, and the total number of letters will be 6, and we have to arrange these 6 letters among themselves, and this can be done using 6P6 ways, that is 6 factorial. Now the next type, when repetition of object is allowed. So here, up till now, we have considered that repetition of the letter is not allowed. Repetition of the object is not allowed, and now we'll consider that repetition of the object is allowed. So the number of different permutation of n distinct objects taken r at a time, when every object is allowed to repeat any number of time, is given by n raised to r. Okay, so here is the first example. How many 4 digit numbers can be formed by using digits 2, 4, 6, 8 when repetition of digit is allowed? So here the total number of words of 4 is, now for the first place we have these possibilities for 4 places. For the first place we have 4 different possibilities. The first digit can be 2, 4, 6, 8. Okay, so for first position we have total 4 possibilities. As the repetition of object is allowed, we can use this digit which is placed at the first position at second position also. So at second position also we have again 4 different possibilities. Similarly, at third position we have 4 different possibilities, and at fourth position also we have different 4 possibilities. That means total 4 raised to 4. Okay, I repeat, at the first position we have total 4 possibilities. You can select any of the number 2, 4, 6, 8. Okay, so suppose 2 is selected at the first position. Now at a second position, as the repetition is allowed, all the 4 digits are available to be placed at the second position. So again we can select the numbers from 2, 4, 6, 8. Similarly at the third, and similarly at the fourth position. So as the repetition is allowed, the all 4 numbers are available at each of the digit to be placed. So that is the number of possibilities equal to 4 into 4 into 4 into 4. That is equal to 4 raised to 4, which is equal to 256. Next example, find how many codes of length 5 can be formed if the first 2 are letters and next 3 are digits. No letter is repeated, but digits can be repeated. The similar type of question was also discussed in a last video, but here the change is the digits can be repeated. Okay, so the first 2 letters can be selected by using, first letter can be selected by using 26 P1 ways, because you have total 26 letters, out of which the one letter is to be selected as a first letter. The one letter is selected here. So for the second position, you have only 25 options. So 25 P1, because the condition given is no letter is to be repeated. So 26 P1 multiplied by 25 V1, like we do in normal permutations. Now the next is, we have to select the three digits. But for three digit, the condition is that the digits can be repeated. So for first place, we have total 10 choices. Similarly, for second place, we have 10 choices, and for third place, we have 10 choices. If the repetition is not allowed, then we do it 10, 9, 8. But here the repetition is allowed, that's why for all the position, the 10, all 10 digits are available for the placement. So this can be done in 26 P1 multiplied by 25 P1 multiplied by 10 into 10 into 10, that is 10 raised to 3, which is, these many words can be formed by this combination and by this condition. Okay. Next type is, when objects are to be arranged in a circle. So if the objects to be arranged in a circle, then for n objects, there are total n minus 1 factorial permutations are possible. Okay, so we'll consider a couple of examples for this. How many ways can the letters A, B, C, D, E, F, that means total 6 letters, be arranged in a circle? So here n is equal to 6. The number of ways to arrange letters in a circle is 6 minus 1 factorial, that is equal to 5 factorial, which is nothing but 120. Next example. In how many ways 10 programmers can sit on a round table to discuss the project, so that project leader and a particular programmer always sits together? So there are total 10 programmers are there, including one project leader, and the condition is that the project leader and a particular programmer should always sit together. Okay, so like we have just now discussed the example, the two is always together, so that two is considered as a single unit. Here also the project leader and a particular programmer will be considered as a single unit, so they are considered as a one unit, because they has to be sit side by side for the discussion. Okay, so the total number of people here will be 9. So the total number of permutations will be 9 minus 1 factorial, that is equal to 8 factorial. Here you may have one doubt, that two person means a leader and a particular programmer, they are two person, and that those two person can be arranged in themselves by 2 factorial. But as here the arrangement is in circular order, again the 2 minus 1, that means the to arrange 2 person in a circular order, we have only 1 factorial choice, that means the 1. So that 1 factorial is neglected over here, and so total number of permutations equal to 9 minus 1 factorial, and that is equal to 8 factorial. Thank you. This is all about the permutation problem, with kind of some different types of problems. I hope you are enjoying my videos, and these videos are helping you to clear your doubts. If you like my video, please press like button given below the video. Please subscribe to my channel. If you have any queries, you can ask me through comment section. Thank you. Thank you very much.